finish my talk today, 4 people will be get killed in our Indian roads due to road traffic crashes. And 1 female will be raped in our country. So that is the severity of the problem. And that's why we need to create our cities safer by design. Why cities? I think most of the people in this room has been migrant from some other cities or villages or small towns. Why people come to cities? Cities are engine of growth. Cities are land of opportunities. Many people come to cities for jobs, better education, and better healthcare. So when we shift to cities, our aspirations are very big. What we think is that we are going to get lot of opportunities in our city. I also shifted from a very small and poor district of Orissa called Kalahandi. I shifted to Delhi 22 years back for my education and shifted to Gurgaon 10 years back for my job. I never looked back. But when I see my city, and what we think is that, you know, the most important thing that we want from our city is quality of life. And are we getting that from our city? Cities are full of challenges. When we look into the city, there are mountain of problems in our city. Either it is solid waste, garbages, water problems, housing, mobility, how we are moving from one place to another. And there are huge other problems. But the major problems which is hugely neglected in our city is safety. There are various kind of safety challenges in our city. There are cyber security problems, there are crimes, different kind of crimes. There are many other issues, energy security, many other security issues in our city. But today, what I'm going to highlight is 2 major safety issues which is never have been highlighted or has been raised in our city. That is road safety and safety of women in our cities. So, road safety, why even we are talking about it? So, if you will be surprised to know that India is the capital of road traffic fatalities. Every year, we lose around 1.5 lakh people due to road traffic crashes, due to this horrible incident. And WHO, after looking into all this data globally, has been recognized that road traffic fatality is a severe epidemic. It is not just an accident, we always call it that, you know, we brush up, it's called that it's a fate or it's like, you know, by karma, something happening. But it is an incident which is avoidable. It's not just 1.5 lakh people get killed, but as per WHO data, it is 33% more than what the actual number is. And it is not about people getting killed. It is about million plus people are getting killed and getting severe injuries. And it is not about that million plus people. It is about that million plus family who get impacted by this incident. The family suffers because 70% of the people who are getting killed are the bread earners of the family. So this is the severity of the problem. Second, we all know we are discussing a lot in our bedrooms and in our drawing rooms with our friends and family, but we don't know what is the severity, the issue is on women's safety. 1 in every 3 women involved get some kind of sexual or physical violence, face some sexual and physical violence, and it's not a small number. So if you see, again, as leading in India for road safety, India is leading on women's safety also. In 2018 survey, it has been known as India is the most unsafe country for women in terms of crime against women. And we might get, we might agree with this number and all that, but as per government data, in 2017, 3.6 lakh cases get reported, which is crime against women. So this is the severity. And why it is happening is again a question mark. The December 2012 incident, the tragic incident of Nirbhaya, when a young girl was traveling in a bus, got raped and brutally murdered. And same thing happened a week back in Hyderabad. And both the case, if we, compare, is by when women were moving from one place to another. And it happened in our street. Okay, that is like, that is what is the severity when look into our street. So, how to address these safety issues in our city? Okay, we want legislation and we have it. We also need to enforce our law. We also need to educate people about the law and how the severity of the issue is and how to solve this problem. But are these three things are enough? Because we are doing this, we're trying to solve this issue from decades by looking into these three parameters. But we are not discussing or strategizing the most important parameter is how we need to make our cities safer by design. So what we need? So the first and most important thing, as I highlighted, that women get abused is when they are traveling, when they are on street. So most important thing is how we can create vibrant street in our city. So you must be, wondering why we need vibrant street, as most of the people use their cars or use their motorcycles. But you must be surprised to know that 50% of our population in our country walk to their work, walk for recreation, walk to school. So that is the percentage. And the most important thing is the street is the neglected part of our country. The footpaths are the most abused infrastructure in our country. We never see a walkable footpath in any of our city. That's the challenge we are facing. Second thing is 18% the workforce is women, and out of that 48% women walk to their work. If you look into the severity of women's safety also, we need to develop vibrant street. We need to create vibrant street. For example, no woman get raped in Chandni Chowk, right? So why? Because it's a lot of intervention of human to human. There is an eye on street. There is natural surveillance. We don't need CCTV cameras to make our women safe. What we need is human intervention, a active street, a vibrant street. So therefore that, what we need to create is the vibrancy. The picture that you are seeing in this presentation is not from Europe or any American countries or any Latin American countries. It is Leh, Ladakh in our city. 3 years back when I was in Ladakh, in Leh, this street was full of cars. And in 2 years, you can see the transformation. The streets are now full of people, and it is safe now. Second thing is very, very important again, is accessible mobility. Again, you will amused to know that, why we need public transport system. Again, you will say that as many people are only using their vehicles, personal vehicles, so we need more roads. And when I ask my friends in any of the conference, When I asked what is the mode share of the car, they said 70%, 80%, 90%. But you will be surprised to know that only 3% people in India own cars. Only 3%. They are the privileged lot of our country. And what we do, 99% of our street infrastructure are developed for them. It's dominated by them, and there is no end of problems because of this kind of development. Again, 2/3 of our population use buses for their commuting, because that is the most affordable mode of transport in our country at present, not even metro, and lot of other mode of transport. But we are not highlighting that. That is again the most neglected part of mode of transport when we plan and, you know, strategize our public transport system in our country. Again, you will amuse to know that, you know, this how this whole thing changed the life of women. For example, 1 month back, Delhi government has announced free mobility, free bus system for women. And again, it surprised me that how the mode share of the women went up from 25% to 50%. And why? Because women also want to go out and look for jobs and add to our GDP. And this is how the accessible mobility give opportunities to our women also. Third thing, again, this is the bus system in Indore, which is one of the successful bus systems. And you can see, it is just not women and children, even men, together traveling in a bus safely. And why mass accessible mobility is a problem? Because it is not safe, it is not affordable, and sometimes, you know, it is not available also. So that's why we need to improve our mobility system, and especially buses in our country. Third, most and most important thing is inclusive spaces. That is, again, we don't care. Because what we think as a public space is in cities are malls, cinema halls, restaurants, and such things, which is a built infrastructure, right? But public space means green space, open space, where our children can go and play, where our elderly can go and sit and interact with their peers and their friends. And this is what public space is, to interact, to talk, to play. That is what we call a open public space. Again, as per global statistics, every city should have 20 square meter of open green space per person. But again, we are not behind on that also. If we see the major three cities, like, you know, Bombay has 1.28 square meter, Bangalore has 2 square meter, and Chennai even don't have 1 square meter. And I don't know data on Gurgaon, because it doesn't exist, because we don't care. So this is the kind of public open space and quality open space we are giving to our cities. So how we can again create more and more inclusive space is important. This picture is from Rahagiri Day. So Rahagiri Day started in 2013 in Gurgaon and spread out to 76 cities and 18 states so far. Why? Because Rahagiri Day gives that inclusive public space to the children, women, and all road users, where everyone from grandparents to children come and play happily in the street. That's what we all used to do in our childhood, but we've forgotten that. And what we think, our kids are safe inside a box. Either it is inside a car, inside a house with gadgets. But sorry, that don't make our city safe and livable. So what we need, this is again, one of the best picture I have clicked so far at Rahagiri Day. And this kids was coming and playing in an area with her mother, and she just randomly picked up this, you know, that I think she doesn't know the meaning of this, But randomly this picked up for a photo of, and she demanded this, and I think we all demand this. So what again we also demand is a safer street, which is safer by design, by creating more vibrant street, more accessible mobility, and more inclusive, green, open space for our children. That is what we want from our city. As I said, we want quality of life, and we will get quality of life from these three aspects. Thank you.